So you might think I'm looking a bit crazy. I am. I've just filmed this makeup look for a festival makeup thing. So that's why it's a bit crazy. I'm going to film a haul now. So I thought I'd just leave it on. It's totally fine. So lately I've got a few clothing bits and beauty bits that I thought I'd just make a haul out of, because I know you love my hauls and I love filming hauls. So I'm going to start off with the clothes. So first of all, a lovely brand spelled S-H-E-I-N. Contacted me and asked if I would like some of their clothes to do a review and show you on my channel. So obviously I was like, of course, because I've looked on their website before and it's a really, really good website. They specialise in high quality clothing. So the first thing I picked up were these jeans and they've got rips in. And I've been looking for a pair of ripped jeans for ages and they just look like the perfect pair. So this is what they look like. I really, really love them. To go with it, I've seen this jacket that I thought would look really cool. So this jacket, I'm probably not going to be able to like show you now, I'll have to do an overlay of it. It's grey, it's still on the hanger and it's long. Yeah, it's, you're not really getting much justice by watching this, so I'll put an overview of me wearing it. But it's really, really cute and together I love it. I just want to play my top to wear with it though. Both the links for these will be in the description. Definitely check out the brand because it's really good and I love the clothes in there. It's really affordable as well, which is a plus. The next few items of clothing are from Victoria's Secret and Pink. When I was visiting my dad's side of the family down Wolverhampton, I asked my mum and dad if I can go into Birmingham, because Birmingham have a Victoria's Secret and it's literally about half an hour's drive. So the first thing I picked up was this top. It's just a plain white top, but it's got a pink neck and these really cool flower patterns on the sleeve, and the back just says love pink, love pink, and it's got the dog on as well, and there's a little dog here, and it's really, really nice. I think this was about £25 and there's actually a really funny story behind this. So I've seen this on a mannequin, actually not funny but I'm going to tell you anyway. So I've seen this on a mannequin and I was like, oh, I really like that top. So my mum went and asked the woman where we could find it because I couldn't find it in the store. And the only size they had was a small, and I'm an extra small because I feel like it's quite big fitting in pink. So the woman was like, go and try a different style on, an extra small, and if you like the small, we can get the extra small if it doesn't fit, you know what I mean. So I went and tried it on and I really liked it. I told my mum, and then my mum went and asked the woman, and I walked out the changing rooms and they've got this full on mannequin with like four staff around it, upside down on the stand, yanking this top off, and I was like, oh my god. Anyway, they gave us the top and I was like, thank you so much. And then there's another mannequin wearing this sports bra that I'm wearing, and I was like, oh my god, mum, I really love that sports bra. But they only had a medium and I thought I'm not going to stay with them again. So I just walked around the shop looking for another one. But I didn't really find any light, and I thought, I'm only down here a few times a year, I'm just going to ask the mum to have a look on the mannequin what size it was. So mum goes to the mannequin, looks at it, and it's an extra small. So I was like, oh mum, can we just like switch it to the medium? But when I asked the woman and she changed it, the mannequin was also wearing a pair of knickers, and I was like, they look really nice together. So I said to the woman, oh, where'd you keep them knickers? And she was like, oh, we've completely sold out of these, we'll just keep on the mannequin. And I was like, oh, I was just wondering if I was going to buy them. And she was like, oh, that's no problem, stripped the whole mannequin for us, and I bought what the mannequin was wearing because I really liked the outfit. And then they had to like redress two of their mannequins because I took all the clothes off them. So this is what the sports bra looked like. It's like a burgundy colour, and the back, don't think you can see, but the back is like crisscross. I'm going to do an overview of it anyway. And this is what the knickers look like. They're the same colour as the sports bra. And a low rise kind of short style. Because I thought it looked cute. And they've got like lace around the top. And they're just this burgundy colour. So I picked up them and the sports bra on the top. Then the final thing I picked up from Pink was a nightie. And this is like a shirt nightie, and there was four different styles and it was so hard to pick. So this is what it looks like, and on it it says Monday should be optional, and it's really cute. It's pink, basically it's just got grey sleeves, white little things, and it's really, really cute. And it's super soft material as well, it needs washed because I've been wearing it a few times. That's all for the clothes, and then now for beauty. I don't have that much beauty, but I had enough to do a haul. So I remember a while ago telling you I bought some stuff from NYX and I was going to do a NYX haul, but I only end up buying three things and I end up going back. So I'm going to go back and buy some new stuff, but I thought I'd just add these in now anyway, and because someone asked me if I could. So the first thing I got was this butter gloss, and NYX butter gloss, I've never tried before, and they are absolutely amazing. So mine is in the colour Madeleine, and I always wear it. Honestly, I absolutely love it. And the lip liner I bought to go with in the shade, oh, Nude Suede Shoes. So it's this beautiful nude colour, and these two together are absolutely amazing. They're the perfect nude combination. I just can't stop raving about them so much. I'm definitely going to put these in a favourites video. And then I also got the NYX Proof It Eyeshadow Primer, because I don't own eyeshadow primer. So it was time to invest in one, because I don't know, I thought you need an eyeshadow primer, don't you? So I picked up the one from NYX, and I haven't really used this much, so I'll keep using it, and I like it, it'll be in a favourites video. And I've got three more items of makeup. I got two concealers, and the first one is the Last Imperfection Concealer by Collection. I bought this one because I've got number two, which is Cool Medium. Absolutely fell in love with it, so I thought I'm going to buy a lighter one, like for under my eyes and stuff, so I bought the fairest one in Fair. And Collection concealers, if you don't own one, please buy one. They're an amazing dupe for the NARS Radiant Concealer, is that it? They're really, really cheap as well. Great drugstore concealer, one of my favourites. And another one of my favourites I picked up again because I fell in love with it so much. So it's the L'Oreal Paris Lumi Magique like concealer, and I love the packaging for starters, and it's just perfect. You just twist it up and it's really, really brightening. It's on the higher end for drugstore. I think it's around £8-9, but still amazing. Much cheaper than like MAC and NARS and all that. And honestly, I think I prefer this over my high end one. So I had to go repurchase it. And the last thing I got is also another repurchase. So I bought the Max Factor Face Finity All Day Flawless 3-in-1 foundation. Basically, it claims to be a primer, concealer and foundation all in one. All my foundations I own seem to be getting lighter for it, and it's not just because I've got a tan. I've noticed that for quite a while. So I bought this in the next shade up, which is, I used to be Warm Almond, and this is Beige. So I bought in the next shade up, and this is again quite pricey for a drugstore, $12.99. So it's not one of the cheapest you can buy in the drugstore, but I love it anyway. It's one of my favourite foundations, and I had to repurchase because, again, I love it and I wanted a darker shade in it. So I have three more things, and these are like still beauty items. So I've got the Yes to Grapefruit Uneven Skin Tone Moisturiser, and I got this for Christmas and it was amazing. It really did even up my skin tone, so I just picked up another one from Boots. If you're looking for a good moisturiser, definitely try the Yes to range, like the Yes to Grapefruit, Yes to Cucumber, Yes to Tomatoes, I think. They do loads actually, so definitely try the Yes to range. And surprise, surprise, I picked up my wipes again. If you watch my channel for ages, you'll know my Garnier Micellar Extra Gentle Cleansing Wipes are my favourite wipes ever. I buy the white packet and the pink packet. I've got to have these in my drawer. Without these, I'm just screwed. I love them. And the final thing for this haul is the Real Techniques Beauty Blender. Me and my dad were at the Tills and Superdrug, and he was buying like his mouthwash and razors or something, all that jazz. And I seen the beauty blenders, and it looks like it's been chewed up and spat back out a million times over. It's just disgusting, and it's starting to get a feisty smell because I wet it all the time. And I do use it every day, so I thought I'd pick myself up another one. This was on special, it was $4.99 down from $5.99. Not that big of a deal, but I thought I'd pick one up anyway because it was by the Tills when my dad was paying. I was like, Dad, please. I love these sponges. If you haven't tried a beauty blender, you should definitely try one. I haven't tried the actual beauty blender, but I've tried, obviously, the Real Techniques ones, and I'm in love with it. It's so good. And now they've brought out mini ones as well, which I'm going to have to try, but for now, I just stick to my normal beauty blender. Just, like, done all my thumbnail-y things. And I forgot if I ended it. Did I end it? If I didn't, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! I'm going crazy. Take it slow, but it's not typical.